Hi guys, I'm Alejo.
And I'm Andrea from Living Hakuna.
And you're watching Why We Sail.
Today is day number 6. We're still at Korok. We just discovered these two little islands, and they're so charming, so amazing.
On avait changé la pluie, je crois que j'ai dit la dernière fois, là, faut que je voie, parce qu'elle se brille. Nous reprenons vers le nord. Ah, il y a un petit bloc.
Ah, on dirait que c'est le bout. Salut, Captain!
And we're honking along. We put the Jenica up, the isometric Jenica, it's really cool. Or isometric spinnaker, because we've got to do 30 miles and we've got limited time for the incoming tide. So we really want to push on.
It really looks like a bomb went off in here. Yeah. My mission is to get this emptied, cleared up, before Rachel gets up. Good luck with that.
And there you go. Just in a jiffy, just like that.
Thank you. ne fait pas toujours beau à Sainte-Lucie. Nous sommes toujours à Sainte-Lucie. Là, je viens de monter au sommet du fort Rodney qui domine Rodney Bay. D'ici, on voit la Martinique. Nadia est restée sur le bateau, elle me fait coucou.
And you can see it is about 6 o'clock, just after 6, so it's not that early. But our next route is going to go all the way to this little island here.
Not be the last, so I'm going to raise all the sails that we have. It is now like 120, true wind is about 120. So let's see what we can do, what we can get out of Sisu.
There's clearly a feeding frenzy going on up here.
So lucky to be able to anchor in this beautiful lagoon in a hull surrounded by a reef.
But I'm not sure what to do with the weather. Where do I set up everything? So I might give it 20 minutes, see if the weather clears up. If it does, we'll crack on. If not, we'll wait till tomorrow.
Yeah! And we are sailing again. We have a good 10 knots now, apparent.
Is running out as we wait on weather to find a hurricane hole.
Well, it's definitely time to move on.
We see firsthand how dependent we've become on digital navigation. My job saw me up the mast trying to stop a rattle from the wind generator cable.
We are right along the edge of this sandbar, and we're in 12 feet of water, and it says that that's 7 feet of water, and we draw 5, so even though we could go right over there, I don't like to take chances with depth.
Here we are relaxing on Robbie's track on Great Couple Island.
Hello!
I've bought this old catamaran and we're trying to refit it in 2 months to get into the water in May. Go easy on me, but apart from that, enjoy the video.
And I'm Nariana, this is my little husband, Mark.
To be truly honest, we had absolutely no idea what was heading our way. We had a triple reefed main and 3/4 of the jib out, and we were flying along.
Nothing.
No, it's not that. Not that. We're gonna make some pina coladas.
Since we've been lifted up a little bit higher, we're going to lower the dagger boards and just kind of hit it, just hit the leading edge with a little bit more bottom paint as well.
Alright, we're sailing, which is good. I can kind of let the engines cool down and go do a check on them since we've been running them for about 2 hours now, and then see if they look good after 2 hours of running. They're probably gonna look good the rest of the trip.
Like that, another entire day has gone by. So this is pretty much the usual afternoon activity. We got a little video game Minecraft action. Elizabeth has worked on vacay and is now preparing a meal.
Nick, do you feel like we're back in college now?
Without further ado, Ruby Rose 2, Therese, what is she going to be?
She is going to be a Seawind 1370.
How would you say it's going?
It's going terrible.
Our boat in there. It feels so strange to see it pulling in after a year of planning for it and then having it come across for like the past 6 weeks now, and now to finally have it delivered. I can't even describe the feeling.
This is probably the most uneventful passage we've ever had. No dolphins, no whales, but no seasickness either.